Yeah, I gotta be on top of him.
On fire.
Come on, let's talk, man.
Let's do it. Exclusively with the truth.
Uh-huh.
Undefeated. Pound for pound, Picasso. Floyd Mayweather Jr. Floyd, how you feeling today, my friend?
I feel good, but it seemed like you must have won the golden glove, because I see your little gloves. That's nice.
You know how we do, we got to stay to the game. Floyd, first of all, share with us your feeling on Arturo Gatti being a no-show.
Man, I told you guys, didn't nobody believe me when I kept telling all the fans, all the people around the world, that this guy is ducking and dodging me. Now his excuse is that he's sick. He got a stomach flu. Well, I got a head cold. I'm here.
Floyd, what are your feelings about him being sick, but there being a press conference for him tomorrow?
Come on, they wouldn't have no press conference for me tomorrow. But that's how the game is. You know, I just roll with the punches, man.
So how satisfied are you that this fight is happening for June 25th?
I'm satisfied. I'm real satisfied, but it takes two to promote. I mean, I think, reality set in. He can't believe he fight me now. Like, oh my God, what I done? What I got myself into? What I done got myself? He know he got himself into something. Right. He nervous. He scared. He nervous. I know he nervous. I know he got the butterfly. I'm going to keep him scared. I'm going to punish him. I'm going to bust him up.
So how frustrating was it for you to be behind him, after him, and being able to chase him and him running circles?
What's so crazy is he can't come today to the press conference, but he can go tomorrow. If he that sick, he should be in the house the whole week, shouldn't he?
So what can we expect Floyd Mayweather to do to Arturo Gatti in your eyes?
I'm going to beat him. That's the easy work. That's the easy part. That's the easy part. I don't know what, yo, what's he even signing the gloves for? He ain't no legend. I'm the legend. I'm already going down as one of the best. See, he's supposed to be on one glove with me.
In your opinion, who's the best guy that you think Arturo Gatti has faced?
I don't know. I don't know who he fought. I know who he lost to.
You know who he's gonna fight on June 25th. That's all that matters, right?
I ain't worried about who he beat. I'm worried about who he lost to.
And we know
whoever he beat. They went at the top of the game no way. Remember that. He don't never beat nobody who at the top of the game. He never beat nobody at the top of the game. What's up?
Alright. So, Arturo Gatti got 6 losses.
Seven
coming up, as you say?
Yeah, absolutely.
So I guess it's a good thing for him not to be.
Don't nobody want to do an interview with him. He's not entertaining like me. He's not exciting like me. They say he's an exciting fighter. He's a boxer. But I ain't never seen a buster fight it up and commentate at the same time.
Right. So what do you think of Gatti's last two opponents, Duran as well as Jesse James Leha?
I don't even know who Duran beat. And Jesse James Leha is 40 years old. Duran came just for the payday. And if he didn't come for the payday, the guy had been off, 2 years? He had retired and came out of retirement to fight.
Give us your thoughts on Arturo Gatti making comments and statements that he was moving on to his next opponent because of your out-of-the-ring problems.
Why is he worried about what I do outside the ring? I don't worry about his personal life. Why should he worry about mine? That Gatti is really his last name. The only Gatti I know is John Gatti.
I told y'all that Arturo Gatti was scared.
I kept telling you, y'all didn't believe it. And in this fight, it's called Thunder Lightning. Thunder and lightning.
I'm the thunder and the lightning.